Welcome to Medlecto. Today we are going to discuss the muscle attachment to the humerus. In the previous video, we discussed the basic components and the margins of the humerus. In this lecture, we will discuss the different attachments of the muscle to the humerus. So if you didn't watch the previous video, then first watch that video so you can easily understand what will happen in this video. Let's start. So here you can see there are two humerus, and this is the anterior view of the humerus and this is the posterior view of the humerus. There are two views, and we divide humerus into three parts. First is the upper part, second is the middle part, or you can say shaft, and third is the lower part. So these are basically the we divide the humerus into three parts. So first of all, we will discuss the upper part. So first of all, we will discuss the upper part of the humerus. What basic components are present in the upper part? First of all, the important component is the tubercle, greater tubercle and lesser tubercle, and second is the intertubercular sulcus. So this is the second component, which is actually the groove which is present between the two tubercle. Next is the tubercle divided into lesser tubercle and greater tubercle. Lesser tubercle, actually this is the medial side, this is the lateral side, and if we see, this is the lateral and this is the medial side, right? And you see that this one, this is the lesser tubercle, this is the lesser tubercle. Which muscle will attach to the lesser tubercle, and the muscle which attach to the lesser tubercle will be subscapularis muscle. Which muscle will attach to the lesser tubercle? Subscapularis muscle. Next is the greater tubercle. Three muscles will attach to the greater tubercle. First one is the supra scapularis muscle. Second one is the infra scapularis muscle, and third one is the teres minor. So these are basically the three muscles. Here you can see, this is actually the greater tubercle. This is the greater tubercle, and here you can see we divide the greater tubercle into three parts: upper, middle and lower. Upper, at the upper part, suprascapularis muscle will attach. At the middle part, infrascapularis muscle will attach, and at the lower part, teres minor will attach. Here you can easily see that this is the suprascapularis muscle. First is the suprascapularis muscle. Here you can easily see that this muscle, and at the back side you can also see this is the suprascapularis muscle. And next is the this one. This is the infrascapularis muscle, and last is the teres minor. So these are the three muscles which will suprascapularis muscle. You can easily see at the anterior and the posterior both views, but infrascapularis and teres minor you see from the posterior view, and you can easily remember these muscles by the mnemonics sit. Sit is the mnemonic which will help you in understanding what muscles will attach to the greater tubercle. Next, if we talk about the intertubercular sulcus. In intertubercular sulcus, we divide it into three parts. We divide the intertubercular sulcus into three parts. First is the lateral side. Second is the floor of the intertubercular sulcus, and third is the medial side. So, at the medial side, which muscle is present or which muscle will attach at the medial side? So, teres major will attach to the medial side. So, here you can see this is the medial side, this is the lateral side, and this is the teres major muscle, which is actually present at the medial side. And this is the floor. And at the floor, here you can see, this is the intertubercular sulcus. And at the floor of the intertubercular sulcus, there is a muscle which is called the latimus dorsi. Latimus dorsi will present at the floor of the intertubercular sulcus. And at the lateral side, which is this one, which is shown by the green color, this is actually the latimus dorsi muscle. And at the lateral side, which is shown by the green color, this is called the pectoralis major. This is called pectoralis major. And at the lateral side, which muscle is present? Pectoralis major muscle is present. So you can easily remember by the mnemonic. Here you can see the mnemonic will be TLP. TLP will help you in understanding, or which will help you in remembering the muscles of the intertubercular sulcus: teres major, latimus dorsi, and pectoralis major. So these are basically the muscle which will attach to the upper part of the humerus. Next, we will discuss the shaft region. Next is the shaft region. We divide the shaft region again into three part. Deltoid, tuberosity. Tuberosity is actually present at the shaft region. Next is the medial part of the shaft region. And last is the anterolateral, or you can say medial, both surfaces of the humerus, anterolateral and anteromedial surface. These are basically the sides at which the different muscles will attach to the shaft region. At the deltoid tuberosity, which muscle, as name indicate, deltoid. At the deltoid tuberosity, deltoid muscle is present. Which muscle is present? Deltoid muscle is present, or which attached to the deltoid tuberosity. At the medial, here you can see, this is actually the deltoid muscle which will attach to the deltoid tuberosity. Next is the medial side. At the medial side, which muscle will attach? So here you can see, at the medial side, I write it red color. So at the medial side, coracobrachialis muscle will attach at the medial side. Here is the medial side, and in front of the deltoid muscle, coracobrachialis muscle will attach to the medial surface or medial border. And last is the anterolateral and medial surface, this portion. So anterior and medial surface is covered by the brachialis muscle will attach to the anterolateral and medial surface. So these muscles are present at the shaft region. Next, we will discuss the lower portion. So, if we talk about the lower portion of the humerus, we divide it into four regions. So, we divide the lower region into four. First is the lateral, supracondylar ridge. Second is the medial supracondylar ridge. So this is the second one. And further, lateral epicondyle. Next is the medial epicondyle. So these are basically the four parts of the lower four parts which are present at the lower portion of the humerus: lateral supraepicondyle ridge, medial supraepicondylar ridge, lateral epicondyle, and medial epicondyle. So here you can see, this is the medial portion, this is the lateral border. We first of all discuss the lateral supracondylar ridge. Which muscles will attach to the supracondylar ridge at the lateral side? So here you can see, we divide it into two parts, upper two-third and lower one-third. We divide the lateral supracondylar ridge into three regions. You can easily understand, this is actually the portion of the supracondylar ridge. We divide it into three parts. So upper two parts will be for which muscles? The upper two-third part will be for the brachioradialis muscle. For which muscle? Brachioradialis muscle. Here you can see, this muscle is actually called the brachioradialis muscle. So here you can see. And lower one third is occupied by the which muscle? Here you can see, this one. This is the lower of the supracondylar ridge. So lower one third is occupied by the extensor carpi radialis longus muscle. Which muscle? Extensor carpi radialis longus muscle. So this is the extensor carpi radialis longus muscle will attach to the lower one third of the lateral supracondylar ridge. So these are basically the two muscles which will attach to the supracondylar ridge of the lateral side. If we talk about the supracondylar ridge of the medial, so at the medial side of one third, lower portion of the supracondylar ridge, so pronator teres will attach at this side. Here you can see, this is the pronator teres muscle, which will attach to the supracondylar ridge. So the last is the lateral epicondyle and medial epicondyle. At the lateral epicondyle, here you can see, this is the lateral side. This muscle is actually called the common extensor muscle, or you can say common extensor origin. Here you can see what muscles will attach to the lateral epicondyle: common extensor origin. And at the medial side, here you can see, this is the medial side. And at the medial side, common flexor muscle will attach at the medial side. This is the common flexor origin. Actually, there are different muscles. Lot of muscle will attach to the epicondyle, lateral epicondyle, and the medial epicondyle. So we call it common. at the common extensor muscle, four muscles. Actually, four muscle will attach to this side, extensor origin, and five muscles will attach to the common flexor muscles. So, now we will discuss common extensor origin and common flexor origin. What muscles are actually present in them? So, first of all, here you can see common extensor origin. Common extensor origin, four muscles will attach at this side. So you can remember it by C, D. You can remember it by C, D. C, D. Extensor carpi radialis. So here is the first muscles. And second is the extensor carpi ulnaris. So actually radialis brevis, this is the full form of the extensor carpi radialis brevis, extensor carpi ulnaris. And next is the extensor digitorum. Extensor digitorum. And last is the extensor digi minimi. So these are basically the four muscles. And keep remember, here you can see there is a first muscle, there is a second, here is the second muscle, third muscle, and here is the last muscle. These four muscles will combine and form a common origin. These four muscles come and form a common origin at the lateral condyle, epicondyle. And so we called it common extensor origin. And these muscles, keep remember, these muscles are attached to the bones with the help of tendon. Tendon is a structure which actually help in the attachment of the bone with the muscles. So these are basically the four muscles. Next is the common flexor origin. Common flexor origin. Five muscles are basically involved. So you can remember it by L, C, D. So L is the palmaris longus muscle. L is the palmaris longus muscle. Next is the flexor, as the name flexor. So flexor carpi radialis. Next is the flexor carpi ulnaris. And last is the flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. And sometimes, or you can say pronator teres can also attach to the common flexor origin. So here are the basically the five muscle which will attach to the medial epicondyle. So you can remember it by the LCD, and last is the P. You can remember it is LCDP. So L for longus, C for carpi, again carpi radialis and ulnaris, and D for digitorum, and P for pronator teres. So these are basically the five muscles which will attach to the lateral and medial epicondyle. So this is the upper, middle and lower part of the humerus. If we talk about the posterior, at the posterior side, what muscles are present in them? So here you can see tricep brachii. What muscles is present at the posterior side? Triceps brachii. It has three heads. As the name tricep means three. So it has three head. First is the lateral hand. Then is the medial hand. And last is the long head. It has three head, lateral, medial and long. Long head is actually attached to the infraglenoid tubercle. This is not the case. This is actually present in the glenoid tubercle. But lateral and medial head will attach to the humerus. You can see that this is the this one. This green color is actually the lateral head will attach to the oblique ridge. At the oblique ridge, lateral head of the triceps rebecai will attach. And at the lower side, here you can see, this is actually the radial groove at which the radius will part. So below the radius, radial groove, here you can see, there is the medial head. This is the side at which the medial head of the triceps brachii will attach. So here basically the two head will attach to the humerus, lateral and medial. Lateral head will attach to the above part of the radial groove, and below the radial groove there is a medial head of the triceps brachii, and the long head will attach to the infraglenoid tubercle. So this is all about the basic muscles which will attach to the humerus. So here a last thing which you have to remember, actually there are different capsular ligaments are present at the upper and lower parts of the humerus. So here you can see this one is the ligament, capsular ligament, which will attach at the upper and the lower part. So these basically help in the attachment of the bone and it help in the formation of the joint. Keep one important thing which you have to remember. At the upper part of the ligament of the shoulder joint and ligament of the elbow joint. At the ligament of the shoulder joint, between the two tubercles, there is a interruption of the ligament. Actually, it should be continuous ligament. But at the level of the intertubercular sulcus, it will disrupt. Why? Because biceps brachii is the muscle. The tendon of the bicep brachii will pass through the interruption of the capsular ligament. So this is actually the interruption, and between them the tendons of the biceps brachii will pass through this interrupted ligament. So this is actually the important thing. So this is all about the basic attachment of the muscle to the humerus. If you have any question, then you may ask in the comment section. Thank you.